Why OpenAI? Why not your own tech?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, to clarify, Forethought's been around for 4 or 5 years now, applying AI to help customers and help businesses serve their customers better. And so with SupportGPT, we're launching today the world's first generative AI platform for customer support automation. The real big thing and the real answer to why now is that in November, ChatGPT changed the name of the game for the customer experience and for consumer expectations. We've been building for 4 or 5 years, and we've been very focused on correctness, very focused on building a generation of AI that actually can help customers solve their problems. And what we're seeing now is that it's become mainstream for consumers, and that experience, that expectation has risen with ChatGPT. And so we've combined that, and we're building out, and we're launching SupportGPT for customer support.
So this is not a marketing exercise or a PR stunt?
No, absolutely not. And that's one of the things that we wanted to be sure about here is, true to our nature, it's about solving problems for our customers. We actually already have customers betaing and using our SupportGPT platform. Folks like Upwork, the world's largest talent marketplace, are already leveraging this technology in production.
Caro, as we do every day, we asked our audience what they think about just endless announcements of partnerships between tech companies and OpenAI. You know the results as well as I do, Caroline. Respondents think this is a PR stunt, broadly, what we're seeing right now in the industry.
Yeah, and meanwhile, Deon, you say, look, this is about servicing your clients. I'm just really interested in, help me understand here, you're already a leading generative AI company. You're already building your own large language model. What was it that OpenAI has that ultimately you couldn't build in-house?
So most customers, when they interact with customer support, they don't necessarily want to chit-chat. They want their problems solved, first and foremost. And that was the premise that we launched Forethought on all of those years ago, was to use AI to help people to solve their problems. One of the things that people have seen with ChatGPT, hundreds of millions of people have used it, from writers to bakers to friends, family, everything. They have now seen what it's like to interact with a chatbot that's empathetic, that's human-like, that really raises the game and raises the name for customer experience. And that was one of the things that we saw and our customers saw. I started getting texts from heads of customer support saying, hey, our customers want this kind of experience and we're betting on Forethought. And that was actually the spark that actually helped us to realize, hey, there is actually something new here. It is not just a publicity stunt. It is not just, you know, the next fad. It is technology. And we at Forethought have been all in on AI since day one. And so we are staying. We've always been on the forefront. The expectations from customers have risen, and we're rising, and we're launching SupportGPT to go and meet those expectations and bring customers that next level of customer support.
Who's your competition then, Deon? Because we're seeing other key companies that are very close to supporting salespeople, supporting other areas of client-facing individuals, and they're also using OpenAI.
Yeah, the big competitor for us, quite frankly, is the legacy chatbot. There have been hundreds, if not thousands, of legacy chatbots that have cropped up over the last decade or so of innovation. And one of the things that you notice about chatbots is that, one, we've all experienced them, and we've all found that they are super clunky, right? They're manual, they're decision tree based, and they're more artificial than they are intelligent. And so we've set out to actually really transform the way customer service is done. And it's really that host of chatbot companies that we're trying to out-innovate and that we've been out-innovating over the past few years.
Yeah, we've got to go to some more of this breaking news right around Silicon Valley Bank. Can I just, for our audience, ask, are you a customer or client of Silicon Valley Bank?
Yeah, it's interesting. Silicon Valley Bank is one of the banks we actually use here at Forethought. We obviously work with a few banks. So it's interesting hearing the news go out live these days. So really interesting.
Thanks. We don't want to put you on the spot, but I think you appreciate why we have to ask those questions.
Absolutely.
Right, Caroline, that this is happening before our eyes.
Yeah, and ultimately, I have to ask you more on the spot, therefore, Deon. Are you going to be thinking about your relationship with SVB? We're seeing that the shares are extending their post-market decline down by more than 10% at the moment, and a lot of venture capitalists, and I know you're backed by VC, asking their portfolio companies to cut their ties.
Well, it's a really dynamic situation. We're definitely evolving and adapting as we go. But what I can say is, you know, again, we work with multiple banks here at Forethought. And our goal at the end of the day is to best serve our customers, which is, again, why we're launching this SupportGPT. But again, there's a lot happening in the space. And yeah, we're excited and watching what's going on.